Hi, I'm Rebecca from Jobber. Let's go over how to create and edit an invoice. There are a few different starting points for creating an invoice. To create an invoice from scratch, click Create from the side navigation, then click Invoice. Another way to create an invoice is from an invoice reminder on the schedule. Click View Details, and then Create Invoice. And finally, you can also create an invoice from a job page by clicking Generate Invoice. No matter which place you create your invoice from, the process of building the invoice is the same. You'll be taken to a page where you can select the visits and jobs that you want to create invoices for and generate one invoice for multiple jobs, rather than creating and sending one invoice for each job. If you're creating a fresh invoice, unrelated to any of the jobs shown on the page, you can leave the jobs unchecked. Note that marking a checkbox on a job or visit is marking that item as complete from the schedule. Click Next Step. Now you're on the invoice creation page, where you can make any edits you need before the invoice is sent to your client. In this top section, you can include a subject line on the invoice. The default in Jobber will read, "For services rendered." You will see the invoice number in the top right. Click Change to change it. You can edit the issued date. The default will be the date it is sent. You can also change the date a payment is due. It can be due upon receipt, due 15, 30, and 45 days after it is sent. And of course, you could set a custom date as well. This middle section down here is where you can add or edit your line items. If the invoice was created based on a job, the line items from that job will have transferred over here. You can edit the name, details, price, and quantity of each line item, as well as the service dates. Clicking Delete will remove the line item, and you can change the order of the line items by clicking and dragging this icon here. To add a line item, click the Add Line Item button at the bottom of the list. At the bottom of the invoice, you have options to add a client message and change settings for the client view. Here, you can choose if these options are visible to the customer, and this can also be set as a default in your account's PDF settings. Over here, you can view the subtotal, add a discount, edit the tax, add a deposit, view the total, and finally, if everything looks good, you can save the invoice. You will also notice the Save And option with a little drop-down arrow. Here you have the option to save and send the invoice, or you could save and collect the payment right away. For now, I'm just going to save this invoice. Now you can view your invoice, scroll to the very bottom to add notes and attachments, and if you need to edit further, click Edit. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, be sure to check out our Help Center and our other videos.